Hey guys, welcome to the Linux channel. So yesterday I shot a video episode on in case if you're studying in college and about to complete your graduation or college, and if you're interested to become a network admin, and as well as in case or else if you want to become a network software developer, how you can prepare yourself for the same. Whereas in this episode, I'm going to discuss in case if you are interested to work in terms of Linux kernel development and you want to become a full-time kernel developer, kernel software developer, and as well as an integral part of it, you want to become a system software developer. So in those cases, there are various avenues which you can choose, which is what exactly I want to focus in this episode. So what you can do is, in case if you want to be into the career in system software development and as well as kernel programming and things like that, so as a way to start, usually people suggest you need to be good in C, and then you need to be good in various programming concepts and stuff like that. So I don't deny that part, and of course you need to be good at these aspects, and as well as you need to be good at various system level aspects like user space programming, and as well as how various subsystems works in user space, you know, level. But on the other side, this is just one part of the same. Whereas when you get into kernel level programming, you need to be very good at the entire kernel architecture, entire systems architecture to be precise, because we should not forget that it's not kernel means it's just not about Linux kernel. You should be good with respect to OS concepts. You should be very good with respect to, you know, theoretical concepts. Not necessarily, that doesn't mean they will be implemented in Linux kernel. So Linux kernel is just one example of a kernel's implementation, and since Linux is widely adopted and it has been contributed by millions of kernel programmers across the world, we have an advantage because we have various types of implementation of any specific requirement or a problem. Let's think we have process synchronization, or else a sort of synchronization techniques. We have various ways to do the same, and it can be even interrupts. We have various levels of tackling a specific requirement. So this is the sort of big picture I'm just trying to put it in a best possible way, because you are still at the college level and you are still unable to decide what you can do next as such. So the best way to start about this is just analyze yourself. Are you going to be very good and devoted with respect to programming? And in case if you are very much interested in systems level concepts, okay, so what you can do is you can study the theoretical aspects of in general any OS, kernel architecture, and as a part of it you can also understand about Linux kernel's architecture. So I don't want to start, like as I recommend in many videos, I don't really recommend you guys to start seeing or else doing a hello world of kernel module and then claim yourselves as if you started working in kernel level programming. It's just really dumb way to look forward. The kernel programming starts with respect to entire kernel source of Linux kernel. So you need to understand what exactly Linux kernel does and the various subsystems involved. So in these cases, there are also various avenues which you can choose. Let's say, for example, if you are very much interested with respect to platform level concepts, not necessarily you are interested in file systems and you are not interested in networking subsystem and networking protocols and stuff like that. So try focusing in platform level concepts, because you may get a career where in which you can do board level porting. You may have a new board in the market. Say suppose we are getting, after Raspberry Pi 3 Model B, we may get the next release for Raspberry Pi. So in that case, in case if it's processor architecture changes, and in case if it is not backward compatible or else it is partially backward compatible, you need to do some kind of OS porting so that it runs smoothly into that inside that new architecture. So in this case, you need to be very good with respect to platform level concepts, OS concepts. So in that case, you need to brush up those areas, and you need to gain some amount of skills in those areas as well. So other than that, in case if you are interested in security, in case if you are interested in encryption and stuff like that, so you have like two options available in system software context, because you can also work in user space level, you can also work in various scripting languages, you can also implement these security concepts in any Android or iOS apps. So in case if you are interested in system level context, you have like two avenues. One is with respect to file systems and any kind of encrypted file systems and stuff like that, and other than that, you can also choose a different path like networking, and you can work with respect to VPN technologies and network protocol encryption, packet encryption and stuff like that. So you have like two avenues. So in case if you are working in in case if you are interested to choose security, you have all these options. But other than that, you can also choose to be some kind of white hat security guy, wherein which you can find various loopholes, you can find various security issues in a system, and then you can analyze, you can do penetration testing and things like that with various tools, and then you can analyze any issues. And recently we had this dirty cow issue in the Linux world as well. So things like that. So in case if such things comes, you can work towards fixing these security issues, and you can choose a kind of a domain towards this arena. So in case if you choose any time like that, you need to be good sometimes at systems level, because security doesn't end with respect to file encryption or packet or network or data encryption. It also starts with respect to user level access, process level access. In case if there is a process created by a user, and that process global variables or process resources should not be able to be accessed by some other process of some other user. So in case you have a large server, one should not able to peek into without having super user access. One should not able to peek into these processes. So these are the various things involved. So you need to be very good at platform, you need to be very good at security concepts, and you need to be very good with respect to file systems as well as networking subsystems and things like that. So this is one arena. And other than that, if you are interested in terms of working in storage space, I have seen guys, so many of my well-known friends have been in NetApps as well as EMC. So these guys are very much involved in storage technology. So they are also system software developers, and they also work in kernel level, but at the same time they mostly work with respect to storage domain, and they work with respect to various file systems and fine-tuning these file systems and stuff like that. So this is also one arena wherein which if you are working in storage technology, you just let's take an example of NAS. As you can understand, it's a sort of meeting point of file system, file subsystem as well as network subsystem. So it's a sort of files which are being shared across the network. So you have a sort of meeting point. You need to be very good with respect to storage concepts, file concepts and things like that, as well as with respect to networking concepts as well. So other than that, there are other generic domains available wherein which you can be good with respect to device driver development, or you can work any projects in the companies which they hire you. You may work on projects like graphic cards, work doing device drivers for graphics cards, doing device drivers for network interface cards, NIC cards, or else things like that. Or else you may even work with respect to any device drivers or with respect to USB and stuff like that. So these are all the various things available. So you need to focus which domain you want to specialize. You want to be working towards device drivers, you need to be good with respect to device drivers concepts, as well as kernel concepts, as well as platform concepts, and as well as sometimes these device drivers, in case if you are working on network device drivers, you need to be good at networking concepts. So you need to be good obviously with respect to networking context, and as well as sometimes there are cases when you work, especially in device drivers, especially in networking world, there are cases where you have stuff like offloading. So you need to convert whatever data you received, then and there you may parse this data and then you can populate in SKV, or sometimes it may happen in low level basis, as it depends on specific implementation. I'm generally generalizing as much as possible. This is not really about you being a Linux kernel developer. So let's just generalize this entire video title, so that you need to be choosing a career where you are working in systems level in kernel development. So one of that may include Linux kernel. So that in that understanding, I'm just trying to make these things as clear as possible. So in case if you want to specialize in device drivers, these are the things you need to focus. So you need to be good in systems level context and concepts. You need to be good with respect to platform and OS level concepts. You need to be good with respect to networking and file systems and various device registration, and you can refer, of course, the LDD book, and Linux device drivers book, and then you can try various sample programs which has it has been written in LDD book, and you can change around, and you can also compare with respect to existing Linux device drivers. You can just go through Linux kernel source and you can read any sample device driver implementation, and you can compare with the book, the LDD book, whichever it is available. You can compare with respect to real implemented device driver, and that way you can get a mastery of the same. So you have all these avenues put in front of you. So you can be a generic platform level guy, wherein which you can do porting, you can do in general maintenance and bug fixing and stuff like that. Especially these guys deal mainly with respect to porting and board level bring up and stuff like that. So you have a fresh board and you need to have a proper stable working Linux on top of it, Linux kernel on top of it, so you can work on these things as well. So one is platforms, the other possibility is being an expert in device driver development. So there is not much overlap with respect to these things. You need to choose exactly which direction you need to go. So it is like, I have seen, this is a sort of confusion I have seen every time I attended long ago, during my full-time career, every time I attended interview, even I have seen large companies, even I have seen Cisco's and Junipers and stuff like that. The big problem with respect to managers over there is they kind of expect guys to be an expert in everything as such, which is not good. You need to be a master in a specific domain. Just make sure you get the right guy for your team. Don't expect somebody who is a platform guy and then expect him to also do a device driver work. So this is a sort of mistake they do. And on top, these companies also ask some primitive questions about linked list and deletion of node. In India, this is quite common. They just ask in an interview about a deletion of a node and stuff like that. This is not makes anyone into a kernel developer. So this is the exact confusion which the companies which hires you, they make mistakes because they think these frequently asked interview questions, like technical interview questions, if you are good at it, they think you are very much eligible for the job. And this is a big mistake. So you need to be good with respect to the real hands-on you need to have on the code. And I can suggest you can start it right away when you are in the college. Don't expect companies also to come forward and teach you, you know, when after you get hired or recruited. So this is your responsibility. When you are in the college onwards, you can choose which domain you need to go. And in case if you are completely interested in user space apps and things like that, you can specialize in Java, you can specialize in user space, C programming, C++ programming, user space scripts, user space scripts, like, you know, scripting languages like Bash, PHP and Python, Perl and stuff like that. Whereas in case if you are focused in terms of working in system software development, and in system software development, kernel development, in kernel development, especially, say, for example, Linux kernel development, then, you know, these are the possible avenues. And so after systems, after being a device driver specialist, you have other options, as one is storage, one is security, one is networking. So you have almost like 5-6 options over here. So one is, as I said, it is all about platforms, OS, porting, OS, core OS concepts. There may be a way Linux kernel is handling processes, and in case if this entire architecture is bad, it is wrong, and it is not going to work out in future architectures, you can completely rewrite, you can invent things. So you can do wonderful things in this aspect as well. So personally, if you ask me, I am not interested in this domain. So in general, I am very much interested and comfortable with respect to working on networking technology. So this is all about my personal comfort and my personal choice and taste as well. So I appreciate OS concepts. In general, I don't like much learning about memory management and stuff like that. I'm just fine. I just use existing APIs, and I focus personally, you know, doing things with respect to my networking subsystem modules. So this is my personal choice. So similarly, in case if you are interested with respect to core OS concepts, you need to be a good platform level guy, and don't ever choose device drivers, because that's a complete different domain altogether. So device drivers guy should be good at OS level stuff to an extent, but he is also supposed to focus a lot about writing device drivers. The next comes is security guy, and as I said before, he should be very good at all of the above. So along with that, with respect to security concepts, so he need to be an expert in security, but he needs to be good at all the levels almost, because sometimes, you know, you may have even a security chip, and it may even do things in with respect to device driver context, and you need a help of a device driver guy, and you need to give your feedbacks with respect to what you need out of it. So it's like that. So next is storage, and he need to be good with respect to networking and all of the above to an extent. So other than that, the last but not least is, you know, networking guy, system software networking expert, a guy like me. I need to be good at many things, but at the same time, I need to be very, very good at, you know, networking concepts, and I need to be good with respect to building a network protocol stack, analyzing existing network stacks, come forward any suggestions, changes, implementing new RFCs, doing any bug fixing, patching any holes, security holes and bug fixing and stuff like that. So this comes with respect to networking domain. So last but not least, they need to be an expert in networking concepts. They need to be good at system level optimization, because every time you deal things with respect to networking, the packets flow in real time. You need to do data processing in real time, unlike storage space usually, because so often in storage technologies, what happens is when you compress a file in command line, a tarball, let's take an example. So what happens is it compresses this file in offline basis, and then it dumps back the compressed file, the tarball, into the hard asset. So what happens is when you compare this with networking concepts, you know, in networking technologies, what happens is, this is something that happens in real time. Let's take an example, VPN. So when the packets arrive, you know, they get encapsulated and then they get encrypted, and sometimes if you can allow VPN compression, if you enable VPN compression in your tunnels, you know, it on a, as an added you know, processing overhead, it also sort of compresses these packets. So it's a sort of real overhead. So this happens in real time. So this is what exactly, if you're dealing with a networking subsystem, if you're writing a network stack, you need to focus about code optimization, you need to focus about real-time code optimization, and you need to take care of various parameters like system level optimization and measuring the performance of your networking device and stuff like that. So apart from your own code being optimized, but sometimes it all really depends on exactly what hardware you are choosing, or else the company is choosing in terms of building this specific product as such. So these are the things which are generally involved. As a student, you may not much still understand what I'm trying to say here. So put forward in a simplistic way, as a networking expert, you do things in real time. So performance is something very much important, unlike guys working in storage areas. So these are the various things. And last but not least, again, apart from all the above, you can still see there are cases, you may have systems level programmers who may work equally in user space, equally in kernel space in general. So they may work throughout any layer. So sometimes you may have some user space application, a C daemon, which is communicating with the kernel space routines, kernel space modules, and then it is getting some sort of services and giving some services to the users. So in this case, you may work in the entire systems level development. So these are the various avenues. But in terms of core kernel space programming, you have almost 5 avenues, and you need to choose exactly which it suits you and which you are really interested almost working on the same almost throughout entire lifetime of your career. So take a decision and take some time and take a decision in case if you want to work in kernel level programming, take a decision and don't wait till you get something like recruited in campus, and then don't allow a company to choose what you are supposed to be. So take time, and in case if you are interested networking, in case if you are interested in security, or in case if you are interested in storage or a generic platform or else device drivers, take a decision by yourself. Don't allow the company to take a decision, and try to get mastery on the same by yourself as such. Don't expect the company to give any sort of training in general as such. So obviously they do, of course, conduct corporate training and stuff like that, but it's like spoon feeding stuff, so which I don't much appreciate as such. So you need to have a system at home, you need to build a small lab, you need to work on these things as such. So it's just, this is what I kind of put forward as such. So hope you guys liked watching this video, guys. And in my previous episode also, there are a couple of guys have sent me emails and as well as contacted me in YouTube, discussed via YouTube comments. So in case if you also have further queries or else any confusion in terms of choosing your own career, because this is something which is not much guidance you get, because as one can understand, there is something, as you do courses in Java and get specialization in Java, you will become a Java developer. There is nothing about it. And other than that, you are good at you are interested in database, and you are good at grasping SQL concepts, and you are good at in general understanding the entire flow of database and optimization of the same and things like that. You will end of the day may become a database admin, and you may work in technology is something related to the same. You may even do an architecture of the same, and you may even work down the lane, you may work on e-commerce solutions, and it all depends on exactly how you are posted as. Whereas if you want to be a core systems level programmer, and this is where exactly the guidance you may not get properly on the net, or you may not get properly. It's just I worked in Tata Elxsi and few companies. I've seen people will be get recruited, and eventually they will be pushed with respect to client projects, and by the time they complete their 5 years, they themselves don't know exactly what good they are at. And this is exactly the reason it happens in IT industry. After some time, they feel they are obsolete, and they just at the mercy of these companies who hire them, and they train them, and then they get work out of them. After some time, they themselves, they don't know exactly what they are very much good at. So once you take as a manager, if they take such resumes, they don't know exactly this guy is good at exactly core level which domain, because he may work 1.5 years a project on networking. After that, he may suddenly jump on a different project, and he may be working on something level, something like board level porting, or some sort of platform level work. After that, suddenly they may shift him to some storage level storage space project. So this is just a mess. It's not something that guy, he will tell that, I later joined in some other company, and then they gave me this particular project, and then I started working. It says a hint that this guy doesn't have control on his life. It's just the company where he gets hired, he just does whatever project, it is just thrown on him, and we don't know what is the level of contribution he had given back. So these are like, it raises a suspicion even for interviewers. So it's just not, there is a misconception. People assume I put lot of experience, lot of projects in my resume, and my resume will get shortlisted or something. It's just not the case. The recruiters will see the managers, or else your team leaders who you are attending the interview, they are definitely going to scrutinize your resume. The more projects you put is just more they are going to scrutinize, and it's all boils down with respect to total time versus your projects. So you are claiming that you have done like 3 projects in a year, it's just raises suspicion. So that's what it is all about. So hope you guys liked watching this video, guys. So in case if you have questions, send me across. Thank you, have a nice day. Bye bye.